Kia ora, I'm Miriam McCummel. It's the story of the week, the visit of controversial Canadians Lauren Southern and Stefan Molyneux. The alt-right duo spark fiery debate and protest wherever they go. And here, in Aotearoa, it's been no different. For many, their views amount to hate speech, which reinforces dangerous, racist views. But for others, they're champions of free speech, agitators for open discussion and debate. You might not like what they have to say, but should they have the right to say it? Here's Tania Page.
I'm not leaving because of these people.
They can say whatever they like, and there's really nothing that any of us can do about it.
The brain of a 25-year-old black man and the brain of a 25-year-old white man.
No, different sizes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
This narrative is on the rise. It's scary.
People are taking offence to what you're saying.
I don't think she's being hateful in it. I think she's provoking.
Yeah, no, you can't ignore them. You should challenge them.
I love to be proven wrong.
On their first visit down under, Canadians Lauren Southern and Stefan Molyneux got exactly what they came for. Controversy and attention.
What are you smiling at? We hate you!
Hundreds bought tickets.
She's awesome. She's got really cool political views.
Things that a lot of us are thinking but we don't really get to say.
But when they came here, they were shut down.
This rally is for us.
Their event cancelled at the last moment as a crowd gathered in central Auckland.
Why can't they come out in a forum like this so everybody can hear it? Why can't, you know, what are they afraid of?
You know, when you're speaking hate and dividing people, that's not a New Zealand culture. It's not the New Zealand way.
I actually do think the speakers have a right to speak, but equally we should be allowed to show and speak that we oppose that.
For 5 days, we've been challenged on this story about whether we should even be telling it and talking to them. I'm here at Friday's protest, and the size of the crowd shows us the depth of feeling. We think it's an important discussion we should be having, that our society should be having. So here it is.
Hey guys, Lauren Southern here with Stefan Molyneux.
Can you say it for me? It's okay to be white?
Well, I wouldn't consider myself white.
Can you say
white.
It's okay to be white?
You yes, wouldn't consider say. Yourself white?
No.
What would you consider yourself?
Indigenous Māori.
Okay.
She calls herself a journalist, he a philosopher. To sociologist Paul Spoonley, they represent a rising tide of resentment.
People who are feeling very anxious about what they see as these culture wars, and they're feeling that their country is being undermined, particularly by immigrants or by Muslims.
You will not replace us!
He says they're part of the alt-right.
The new incarnation of a ultranationalist and sometimes a white supremacist tradition.
But Paul describes Southern as more alt-right light.
Lauren Southern is at the polite end of that spectrum.
She's horrific, run! Run for your life!
Massey University Professor Spoonley has researched the evolution of hate speech since the 70s.
You had a very full-on, crude racism. Now, when it comes to someone like Lauren Southern, you know, we have people who are articulate, who are thoughtful, and who then express similar views, but in a much more sophisticated and acceptable way.
Look at me. This is my campus now.
For many of us, just dipping into the internet and looking at some of these people, you think, well, what's the issue? But of course, the further you go, you begin to understand what the issue is.
Just 5 months ago, she was barred from the UK for this stunt.
I think this is one of the occasions that led to her banning in the UK.
It is. It occurs in Luton. She's got a number of signs there and some posters, which are deeply offensive. I mean, I would be offended by them.
Yeah, I find it offensive. I'm
offended. Is that hate speech?
Yes, I think it is. It breaches not only the hostility and contempt provisions, but it's also causing public disorder. I think it's very incumbent on us to understand how many people do feel like that or are willing to support these sorts of views. Let's make them visible.
Ko te ate awa te iwi, ko Ngāti Raukawa te hapu, no Pāmutana, ahau, ko Elliot, ahau. Probably for the last, I guess, 16, 17 years, I've spent both my professional and personal life working within our at-risk karangatai and at-risk whānau.
Youth worker Elliot Ikile lives in South Auckland.
It's a mixed area. And by mix, I suppose I mean mix in every way. Jana was one of the only ones.
He's helped dozens of teenagers find their way.
I've seen young people who I've worked with at airports or working in a high-level job, or they're alive, or that I see them sometimes on Facebook and they're smiling and they're happy.
He's also a staunch conservative and a big fan of the Canadian peer.
The topics that she's speaking about, I think, are incredibly important for our society. We seem to be on a trajectory somewhere. I'm a little uncomfortable with where that trajectory is going.
Don't you dare tell me what I am allowed to hear, what I am allowed to think. I'll make my own decisions.
Free speech is incredibly important in this country. We need to be able to have the ability to bring out issues and problems that we see going on in society.
One of those problems, Elliot says, is multiculturalism.
Multiculturalism doesn't work. We are a bicultural society. Kaupapa Māori, kaupapa Britain.
Do you think that's under threat?
I think that as soon as you impinge on free speech, all bets are off. The concern that we have is the system, the codes, the laws, the cultural practices that are to be maintained as part of a nation. That's the issue.
Can you put yourself in the shoes of that community and imagine the most offensive thing someone could say coming here to your home? Wouldn't you be offended if somebody came here and said that?
First off, in terms of what Lauren did, I think it was a very measured response. I would say that she's provoking a response in order to engage in discourse.
I'm everything that they're against. I'm Muslim, I'm black, I'm a refugee, I'm a feminist.
Community leader Fatoumata Ba and Lauren Southern are the same age.
Having a young person with such extreme ideas that almost reverse humanity back 100 or so years is something really hard to understand.
For her, Southern and Molyneux have no place in New Zealand.
I'd like to think that we've kind of surpassed that time, you know, where we believe that one race is better and above all. And I think that's fundamentally the message that these individuals are bringing.
Living here since the age of 3, Fatoumata has seen firsthand where that message can lead.
We're going to Posti Plus, and then a Pākehā middle-aged woman thought that she would be friendly and offer us a ride to the airport. For us, that was kind of noted that, okay, you don't belong here, you need to get out. You know, for some people, the fact that I even might, like, you know, wear my hijab is a sign of my extremism.
The reality is, the face of New Zealand is changing, and a new campaign celebrating the words of Kate Sheppard recognises this.
Even though it's been 125 years since we have received the vote, there's still a lot of work that needs to be done.
Those which appeal to the principles of justice and equity.
With the right to free speech is the responsibility to do so in a manner where you don't cross the line that is hate speech. As long as your message is putting down another group of people because of their gender, sexuality, ethnicity, religion, then you are at the point where you're crossing that line.
Coming up, the reality of hate speech in New Zealand.
Something about hoping I will meet a slow death.
What to do about it.
Look, I don't think that we can just keep ignoring it.
And where some people think it comes from.
I don't actually believe in the concept of hate speech. You have the right to say stupid things.
Lauren Southern and Stefan Molyneux are in the trenches of what's known as the culture wars. They claim their views are being shut down.
Free speech
is under significant attack and is crumbling, in particular in places like New Zealand.
But in the age of the internet, free speech has never been freer.
There's no obvious barriers for many people to saying things that are really extremely hurtful and hateful.
Martin Cocker's team at NetSafe investigates online abuse.
So we're up over about 60 cases a week. There's a specific protection for free speech in the Harmful Digital Communications Act, and every time the team works through a case, they have to review it against someone's right to free speech.
But this act only covers abuse towards an individual, not this kind of thing.
I'll be arrested.
Yes, you will.
How you can say the God is gay?
Sir, please don't swear.
The God is create everything, he's not gay.
They set up a blog or they set up a website, they can say whatever they like on it, and there's really nothing that any of us can do about it.
So he has some advice.
We want to encourage people to step up and say, we find this offensive for these reasons. It's probably more realistic than thinking we can block them or stop them from having a platform.
3 weeks ago, that's exactly what Green Party co-leader Marama Davidson did.
I needed to let those people see I'm not budging, that I'm very clear that freedom of speech is being used as an excuse. Those of us who have a platform, I believe, have a responsibility to put up the inclusive and progressive values that I know this country holds dear to.
She used her Facebook page to speak out against Southern and Molyneux.
They use science to justify that brown people, people with dark skin colour, are less intelligent and more violent. That is literally the definition of racism, holding superiority over another group of people. So they drum up and empower people who themselves harbour racist and ignorant, hateful views towards other people.
And you got some abuse.
Something about hoping I will meet a slow death, it went on and on and on for quite a long paragraph, and called me a very, very abusive, offensive language towards me that people call women. Starts with C.
In speaking out against hate speech, Paul Spoonley has also received threats.
Here's a case that I had to report to police because people were making threats of violence against me and my family. And I mean, it's very distressing.
So should we be talking to them?
Yes, I think the media should talk to them and you should challenge them.
I see right now the Western world as one front. We are fighting for one of the greatest civilizations that has ever existed. And we're throwing it all away just for the idea that we need to be tolerant.
We have spoken to some Muslims in New Zealand who are afraid, though, that the messages that you bring may lead to them facing some kind of abuse, whether it be physical or online.
What they're afraid of is not that I'm advocating the harm of other people. They're afraid of their worldview being critiqued. I don't shut down those who...
If you favour freedom of speech, you must welcome opposing views.
Of course, of course. I love opposing views. I love people who disagree with me. I have plenty of people in the Islamic community who say the most hateful, awful things about me, and I think they should have every right to their free speech. The problem is that we in the West are very tolerant of other people, but what about the cultures that aren't tolerant of us?
But people with different values and beliefs can live and exist side by side.
They don't. We see people segregating, self-segregating into areas. We might as well have balkanized states within our country. And
that
we're allowing that to happen
extreme
in our own country.
I mean, it's natural for if Somalis come to Auckland for people to live together because they share a language, they miss home. That doesn't mean that they want to create a little Somalia and
they do
take over Auckland.
Well, that's the thing. They do create their own little communities, and if they become the majority,
but
that.
But then, if you think like that,
but you can look at it happen. You don't have. Yeah. There are a lot of threats to our civilization.
Are we prepared to make this beautiful sign even more beautiful?
When Lauren Southern talks about her civilization, what she means is white people.
The statement "It's okay to be white" should not be provocative. It shouldn't be daring. It doesn't matter what happened historically to say that. It is okay that I've been born with the skin color I'm in. I am not responsible
because
for the
we all sit in a context. There's a lot of historical context to white and what it is to be white, what it is to be black, and who's oppressed
and who
isn't oppressed.
Should that change the fact of it being okay to be one race or another? Because no one has a choice over that.
Would you say you're privileged?
No more than anyone else that was born in a Western country.
Their views and what they represent have been privileged forever. White supremacy, racism, bigotry. If you don't have an analysis of power, privilege and oppression alongside your desire for freedom of speech, then you are not standing for true freedom of speech.
A middle-class white person arriving here from Canada in virtually every dimension is not disadvantaged, is not a victim.
Stefan, the claims that race is linked to IQ is something that you've promoted.
I've had a wide variety of experts on the show who have talked about the fact that IQs do differentiate between the races, because I think that facts are important when it comes to talking about things like ethnicity. And so this is very well understood, very well studied.
It isn't the case that it is undisputed. It is disputed. I mean, the person that came up with the IQ testing accepted that environmental factors played a huge role in intelligence.
I've never denied environmental factors. Anybody who talks about this gets the inevitable label of racist, although
it's
against science.
But maybe that's because the majority of science doesn't support it.
No.
Do you have evidence for that?
Yeah, the majority of science does support that.
I detest their views.
They will repulse many people.
It's important that we continue to call them out, to call them to account, and say to them, stop using freedom of speech as an excuse for hatred, racism, and bigotry.
And resonate with some.
It's one of those moments where we begin to prick the New Zealand conscience around some of these issues.
And that's good?
I think it's good because it raises visibility. It's good because we're having a discussion about hate speech and free speech.
Fatimata agrees, but has this message for the Canadians.
There is a way in which you can do this, and the way that you're currently doing it is not acceptable and will not be tolerated.
Rather than using our differences to create division, she says we should embrace them.
Diversity of thought, which is basically what they're advocating for, doesn't come without diversity in religion, in culture, and in the values that we hold.
Aye, hefakaro pai. Hard to argue with that, isn't it? Many of you didn't want us to tell any story involving Southern and Molyneux. There were even calls for our program to be boycotted before the story aired. We've seen it now, and we're interested to hear your thoughts. Do message us on Sunday TVNZ.